Felloni.
Wow. Magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Wow, ang dami nyo. Nagkagulat po kayo. Well, allow me to say sa umpisa na ako isang simpleng parish priest. No? Hindi po ako isang theologian. Hindi po ako isang teacher. Ako ay isang simpleng pare na laging po na-assign sa mga mahirap na parokya. So yung tatlong parokya ko, ang unang parokya ay Payatas. I was there 12 years in Payatas. Then 6 years, Barangay Commonwealth. And now 4 years in Camarin, Caloocan. So, nung ako'y inimbita to speak about this, yung topic hindi po akong napili, binigay lang sa akin itong topic na ito, It's a Beautiful Life, Human Dignity Reloaded. Sabi ko, ano ito? No, siguro kayo din, no? Ano ba ito? Tungkol saan? So, I called the secretariat and I said, tungkol saan po ito? Anong gusto niyong sabihin ko? Kasi yung reloaded, sounded to me to double barrel. Ewan, siguro ako dahil naka-assign po ako sa lugar na may problema sa droga. So it sounded, sabi ko, gusto niyo tungkol sa drug rehabilitation program? Basta kayo pong bahala, basta. Edi, so kung ganun, ako pong bahala. So, I chose to speak about two ministries na ginagawa ko presently na hindi po kasama, strictly speaking, sa trabaho ng parish priest, but deeply related. Una is yung mission sa social media. Lalo-lalo ang mission through social media para sa mga millennials. Yung hindi alam kung ibig sabihin ng millennial, ibig sabihin, yun na yun, matanda na kayo, kaya hindi nyo alam. Sila, alam na nila kung sino sila. And then, yung mga OFWs na yung po ang mga big audience sa social media, I want to talk about that. And if you say, why about dignity? Kasi feeling ko that for the longest time, the church looked at Facebook as a waste of time. So I want to talk today about Facebook as an opportunity. And God given opportunity to evangelize. And the people on the other side are real people. So I want to share that experience on the dignity of people that are pumaghapon sa social media. Hindi ho yung mga addict na walang ginagawa, kundi Facebook ng Facebook, kundi are real people with real needs. So I want to share about that. At anong approach na ang simbahan ay pwedeng may bahagi dito sa mundong ito, sa larangan ng social media. At yung pangalawang parte, I will share about the community-based rehabilitation program that we started in our parish in Camarin on September 1. So magwawaniya ngayon September, and currently we have 54 drug dependents na araw-araw pumapasok at nagpapa-rehab tungo sa graduation. At yung graduation is officially delisted from the PMP watch list. The only way to be delisted na hindi po dumaan sa funeraria. Delisted na buhay. Okay? And so, this is an initiative that the church is having. Maybe not many people know, but so many places around the country are starting this community-based rehabilitation program. So I want to share about these two things. Ito po yung take ko sa Beautiful Life, Human Dignity Reloaded. Kung hindi yun ang gusto ng organizers, malalaman nyo kasi next time hindi ako iimbitahan. So, abangan. Okay, let me share two inspiration from the scripture para sa approach na ito. Number one is John 3:16. Isang gospel na dapat nasa ulo ng bawat Katoliko at higit sa lahat nasa puso ng bawat Katoliko. For God, we can read together. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. And this is my first reflection. Yes, nagpagi tayo, nanalo tayo because God loved us. Sa totoo lang, kung alam mo ang dungis ng sarili mo, kung alam mo ang iyong sariling kahinaan at kasalanan, it's a miracle that God will look at us with love. But yun po ang pinakanaramdaman nating lahat. Yes, God loves me. Do you feel that way? Do you feel that way? Napakabuenas natin. It is a proclamation of great joy that comes from being loved. The best feeling in the world is to be loved. And na-experience natin yan sa Diyos. And so, if God so loved the world, who am I not to love the world? If He who knows all the darkness and evil in us loves us so much, who are we to hate our world? So, yung pong first principle, the world is something to be loved. Kahit anong world, kahit ang mundo ng droga, kahit ang mundo ng social media, kahit ang mundo ng politics, kahit ang mundo ng prostitution, kahit anong world, our challenge is not to judge the world, but to love the world. We are sent to love, period, not to judge, to love. Because God so loved the world. So, ang unang prinsipyo ay sa lahat ng larangan, sa lahat ng mundo, sa lahat ng sitwasyon, God loves that situation. And because He loves, He wants better. Because He loves, He wants transformation. And so, first principle, our love for this world, sick, fallen, wicked, and all, brings us to embrace the world. And always to immerse ourselves in the world with a heart full of love. So if we love a world, our job is bumaba, makihalo-bilo, at yakapin anumang mundo. So I will talk today about embracing two different worlds. The world of Facebook and the world of drug dependence. Ang layo sa isa't isa. But these are two realities kung saan ang tao ay naroon. At dahil naroon sila, mahal sila ng Diyos, at ang ating trabaho ay umabat, yakapin, mahalin ng lubusan. Second principle, He said to them, go into the world, preach the gospel to all creation. This is the second principle I want to share with you today. The key word is go. Nagulat ako, no? Reading the gospel, ang huling habiling ni Jesus ay humayo, hindi halina. Napansin niyo yun? Huling habiling ay yung pinaka-importante, di ba? Yung huling habiling, kung ikaw ay mawawala na, gusto mong maalala ng mga mahal mo, ang pinaka-importante, di ba? Halubilo ka sa mga anak mo, andyan sila lahat sa ospital, mamamatay ka na. Tapos ano sasabihin? Yung pinaka-importante, mga anak ko, kayong mag-awa. Hindi naman sasabihin na, pakainin nyo yung pusa. Di ba? Kung mamamatay ka na, hindi mo iniisip yung mga kanyang bagay. No? Huwag makalimutan patayin yung ilaw, ilak yung likod. Mga alag, yung chinelas, iwan nyo sa labas. Hindi. Pag huling habili, kung ano pa talaga ang... Kasi huling na nga eh, huling. Ito po, remember, Mark is the last huling habili ni Jesus. Paakyat na siya. This is right before the ascension. Ang kanyang huling habili is, humayo kayo. Go. Hindi halina. Humayo. Ang huling habili ng Panginoon. A church that looks at the world not as a place to escape from, but a place to go with a message. Ang huling habili ng Panginoon is, lumabas kayo. Kaya si Pope Francis sobrang nag-i-insist, isang simbahan na nakakalabas, lumabas, go to the peripheries. Di ba narinig niyo kay Pope Francis, sabi niya, minsan when I pray, I imagine ang simbahan nakalak yung pintuan at ang Panginoon na kumakatok. But not from outside na gusto niyang pumasok, from inside na gusto niyang lumabas. Kasi minsan binablock natin sa loob ng simbahan. I just attend the talk of Bo Sanchez a while ago. Umaten ako sa kabila. And he shared about his mission to the unchurched. He showed the statistics. na 16% lang ng Katoliko sa Pilipinas ay nagsisimba. So 84% ng Katoliko hindi nagsisimba. We have to realize, sabi ni Pope Francis, sabi ng Ebanghelyo, iiwan ang 99 para hanapin ang isa na nawala. Sabi ni Pope Francis, sa mundo natin ngayon, yung 99 ang nawala, isa lang naiwan. And that reality, that's our situation. More people outside than inside. We have to go. A missionary church is a church that goes and embraces the world as it is. And so, second principle, we never observe from outside. We are called to go right into the world and to bring a good, positive message to people and to realities. We never look from outside. Kapag tayo ay tumitingin mula sa labas at nagkukusga lang, ang mundo natin ay lalong tumitiklop sa atin. We never look from outside. We go right in the midst and bring a message. So let me go to the two realities that I want to share with you. The first one. Some pastoral practices. First, social media. Let me tell you the story, how did I enter social media? Ako ay isang convert ng social media. Of course, hindi ako ipinanganak ng social media. Tulad ng marami sa inyo. No? O ako lang. Pwede nga. Karamihan sa ating ay hindi pinanganak. Ako talaga inaamin ko yung last paper ng theology ko ay typewriter pa. So I had a cell phone the first time. I was already a priest. So hindi po ako pinanganak sa mundo ng social media. And I thought, for a long time, social media is a waste of time, especially Facebook. Kaya, I will not have a Facebook account. It's a waste of time. Sayang naman ang oras. Para saan? Ginagamit naman ng diablo yan. I want that kind of mentality. And one day, I went to visit a very good friend of mine, Father John Carroll. Sumalangit na ang kanyang kaluluwa. He's a Jesuit. He was 85 years old in a wheelchair in the infirmary of the Jesuits. And I went to visit him. At sabi ko, Father, lagi nagturo po yun. Sabi ko, Father, hindi na kayo nagtuturo. Siyempre, obvious naman, naka-wheelchair, naka-oxygen. Akala ko obvious. Hindi, akala ko obvious. But he answered, hindi, nag-off ako this semester. Next semester na lang ako. True enough, ha? Nagturo siya the following semester. So I was surprised. And so I asked him, why did you take off a semester? And so sabi niya, gusto kong pag-aralan ito. And so binuksan niya ang kanyang laptop. Gusto kong pag-aralan ito. Sabi ko, gusto niyo pag-aralan yung laptop? Ay, hindi. Matagal na marunong ako. Sabi ko, gusto niyo matuto mag-Facebook, Father? Ano ka pa naman? Matagal na nag-Facebook ako. Ang hindi ko masyadong mabighas ako sa Twitter. And so I was surprised. No? 85 years old, wheelchair, oxygen, Facebook, Twitter. I asked him, why? And he really looked strange at me and he said, but Luciano, you are a missionary, sabi niya. You are a missionary. Kung saan nakatira ang tao, doon tayo mga misyonero. Ang mga kabataan ngayon ay maghapon sa Facebook. Eh tayo hindi. I was really deeply touched. And I came back and I asked the youth in my parish, turuan niya ako mag-Facebook. Because my mentality was like this. Some wrong perceptions. That's when we hate the world, not we love the world. Internet is a waste of time. Hindi ko sasabihin sino sa inyo taas ng kamay, but I'm sure na marami na ganyan ang iniisip. O maraming ang narinig na sinasabi sa inyo, don't use Facebook, is a waste of time. That's a misconception, a wrong perception. Second, there is no real communication in the cyber world. Walang communication yun eh. That's pure ano lang. Gawa-gawa lang na kung ano-ano. I will share my experience with social media. Third, millennials do not have interest in spiritual things. Mga millennial walang pakialam sa Diyos at sa simbahan. Wrong perceptions. And fourth, Facebook is a tool of Satan. Masyadong malubid ito. Sobra naman masyado ito. Now, let me tell you the when you so love the world, internet is a great venue for evangelization. 1 year and a half ago, I started a Facebook page called Almusalita. May pakitas ng kamay kung mayroong nag-like ng Almusalita dito sa inyo. Almusalita is a mix of almusal and salita. The idea is to start the day with the Word of God. We started 1 year ago with a team of my young parishioners. Now we have 65,000 views every day. And it's growing every day, every day. Every week we have 2,000-3,000 new likes and people that watch every day. We started posting a short video, reflection on the Word of God. And you will be surprised the reactions and the reflections. And then people start to ask for prayer. So we put prayer intention. You can check in your Facebook page. And so people add their prayer intention. We have 150 to 100 prayer intentions a day that we offer the mass for them. Now, after a few months, some OFW start asking, Father, nasa Muslim country po kami. Talagang walang simbahan whatsoever. Can you use your live stream and live stream the mass? So I asked the youth in my parish, live stream daw, ano yun? But they said, sa Facebook, makano? Makano? Utang pare, makano? Gastos? Hindi ho, libre po yan. Talaga? Yes. Pwede ba natin i-live stream yung mass? Yes. Ano ba ang kailangan? I was expecting yung anong equipment ang kailangan? Cellphone lang po. Ha? Oo. Now you watch tomorrow. Every Sunday we live stream the mass. 10 to 15,000 people watch the mass every Sunday. Majority is usually 6 a.m. Tomorrow is 6 p.m. for another reason. But 6 a.m. every Sunday. But these are OFWs, on 90% OFWs. And then you start to get the feedback of the people. For example, the other day I was very touched. A Lola, isang Lola, na nag-message sa akin, sabi na yung dalawang apong pinatilyo, college student, na-discover nila yung Facebook page mo. Ngayon, Father, uso namin pag nag-breakfast kami sa umaga, pinapanood po namin. And then we talk about the gospel of the day. Yung apo nag-evangelize sa Lola through social media. And not only that. Now, I wrote a letter through the help of my bishop to the Vatican to ask permission for confession online. And they said, wait for the response, but there are precedents. May mga lugar na binigyan ng pahintulot. Alam niyo na, confession has to be face-to-face. Okay. But I received two stories. One was a OFW on the boundary with the ISIS territory. And they said that we are afraid anytime they will attack our plant. He was working in an oil refinery. And he said, I'm in mortal sin. The second was an OFW sa gitna ng dagat, sa barko. Marino, unos, sabi niya, kung lubog ang barko, pati kaluluwa kong lubog. I'm in mortal sin, I need confession. And I have to answer, I can counsel you, I can pray with you, but I cannot absolve you as of now. But I wrote through my bishop, we ask permission from the Holy See. The Holy See said there are precedents, so wait and we will study further the case. There are so many people around the world that live on Facebook, but they cling to God. And so for you, yung internet is a great venue for evangelization. If we start looking at internet as something bad, and we start looking at it as something positive, we can touch the life of millions of people. Second is, people are hungry for real connection. Social media open spaces for real encounter. totoong people, totoong encounter. Lalong mga millennials, yung mga kabataan ngayon, hinahanap po yun. And you will be surprised how many counseling online. Ito ang mga tao na never will go to a parish and talk with the office secretary and say, andyan si Father, may sasangguni po ako. Wala. They will never do that. But they just send a message. Father, pwede kitang usap, may problema ko. Sige nga. It takes a lot of my time. But my time is for them. Diba? Pareho ako eh. Ang oras ko ay para sa tao. At ito ay tao talaga. Tunay na tao. Totoong tao. Hindi po trolls. Totoong tao ito. And there are thousands, there are millions. And these are people that don't go to church, but somehow find a church in their laptop, find a church in their cell phone, and then connect. At marami sa kanila, I have very many experiences. One girl from New York, Filipina, all Filipina, kasi it's all in Tagalog. Nasabi niya, Father, I was turned down many years ago. Pinagalitan ko ng pare sa confession. So, suma total, nagtampo sa simbahan, nagalit, naglayo, lumayo. And now she was in a big depression. She talked to me, and I said, what can I say? You need a confession. So, find a priest. No. Sa'yo lang, no. You need face to face. It's not because it's a canon of the church. Because you really need a good embrace. You are down. You need that priest to hold your hand, to look at you. Maybe to cry with you. You need that in this sapatang internet. They said, promise me that you will find. But look for a good priest. Hindi ibig sabihin na may bad priest. Pero mayroon. Alam niyo yung iba, pag pinapunta, lalo yung tao, yung kailangan hindi babalik, di ba? Ang dami masungit, no? So go for a priest that you know that is accommodating, can get a big fish, what we call a big fish. Yung mga tao na matagal hindi nagsimba, yung mga tao na like Jesus, no? And she did. And she keeps telling me that she is becoming active in her parish in New York. These are real people, real face. I don't know her personally. But she is a real person. That I know. With real needs. And internet became an instrument to touch such people. Not only that, I can tell you many stories, but let me tell you one more. Ito po is a born-again, baptized Catholic, born-again. And he was my parishioner, territorially, living in the same territory. He had a big crisis in the family. And he went to pray to the Catholic Church. Because the born-agains are a room. But somehow the church is a church 24 hours. So even when born-again want to pray, they found peace in our Catholic Church. So he went to the Catholic Church and he was there. We started the Mass. So after the Mass he said, can I talk to you, Father? Yes. And he said, I've been following you in Facebook. May tanong ako, so tanong siya ng tanong, sige lang. He became close to the parish. And then we invited him to an outing, na sumama siya. Eventually, he became active. And last, what was it? June, I brought him to the seminary. He is a seminarian of the Diocese of Novaliches ngayon. These are real people. Connected through internet, because I realize it's very difficult to go to a priest that you don't know. That you don't know your parish. You enter, you don't know where the office is. It's very difficult. But on Facebook, they can see. Ito, Luciano, ito yata ang parish priest. Message. And with the anonymity of not knowing, they can shoot the first question. Eventually, you relay with the person heart to heart. Young people of today are as hungry as always, or maybe more for God. Don't get wrong. Don't get the wrong perception na yung mga kabataan walang pakialam sa Diyos. Hindi po totoo. Ang mga kabataan ay uhaw na uhaw sa Diyos. Minsan, nagsasawa lang sa simbahan. dahil mukhang luma. At minsan hindi mukhang kaaya-aya. Mukhang masyadong stiff. Mukhang masyadong stricto. But they love the Catholic Church. And they love God. And so never judge the young people. They really are in love with God. And they want the church that they love. They love the Catholic Church. Pero minsan, medyo andating ay medyo hindi gaano ka attractive. Okay. Now, we can use social media for God. We can use social media to serve God. And so, I share this. This is the Facebook page called Almusalita. And we put some ideas that we want. First is to make the Word of God viral. So yung pangunang layunin ng Almusalita is to make the Word of God viral. Minsan, di ba, kung ano nung viral, nakita ng asawa, nakita niya yung kamit niya sa mall, nagsabunutan yung dalawa, may nag-video, 2 million, saka 3 million siya. Magmimisa si Bishop, 5 nanonood. Di ba? Mas patog yung magkabit na nakasabunutan. Why? Because we don't make the Word of God viral. We don't have that passion in communicating. Kaninong kulang? Tayo nga eh. Mas madali yung mga brutal na aksidente, yung mga bloody ng pangyari, yung mga nahuling na MMDA na nangotong. Yun po yung lahat yung viral na God. The Word of God that is way more important and more people are in need to hear that, we sometimes don't make it viral. So our purpose is to make the Word of God viral. Paano? By being cyber missionaries. Sabi ng isang madre sa akin, anong ibig sabihin, Father, cyber missionary? Sabi ko, being missionary in the cyber world. Ah, sabi niya, parang cyber criminal. Oh, gano'n, no, sister, pero mabait ng konti, no? Cyber missionary, cyber crime, no? It's using the cyber world for good. To be a missionary, and it takes only, may lumapit sa akin kanina, pinakita yung cellphone niya, si ate, everyday, sinare mo yung video sa lahat ng contacts niya. So what we said, like, share, and tag your friends. We cannot be a cyber missionary by using Facebook. You can reach people that you never imagined. And so I have a lot of beautiful stories na may nagsabi, halimbawa, naku, Father, nagulat ako. Nabasa ko yung comment ng anak ko na nasa Saudi. Alam niyo nung nandito yan, hindi nagsisimba yan. Tapos ngayon, sabi ng anak ko, siya nag-share ng almusalita sa akin, sabi ng nanay, tuwan-tuwa. Sabihin yung anak ko, yung nanonood, nanginginig. Marami yung ganong stories. And minsan, yung pinakamalayo sa simbahan, yun ang pinaka-active bilang cyber missionary. So be a cyber missionary. Any one of us can decide what to share. The CBCP gave us a good reminder, no? Stop sharing trolls. Discern well kung anong isi-share mo. And I think the same with the gospel. We can share good news. Starting and journeying the whole day with God. Ito po yung layunin ng aming Facebook page, Almusalita. Is to start the day, kaya Almusalita. Ngayon wala, no? Start the day with the Word of God. Mag-almusal with the Salita ng Diyos. Filipino breakfast. Ang tawag namin Filipino breakfast all day. You can watch it anytime. But ideally is to start the day. So nagsimula po kami ng gospel reflection lang, then in-improve yung page. So now we post the gospel in written. We have the video, we have morning prayer taken from the liturgy of the hours. We have the saint of the day. Then we have a quotable quote. We have the prayer intentions. And recently, 2 weeks ago, I talked with Father Jay Liquanan of the Archdiocese of Manila. He has this Catechism on the Go videos, and then we upload their videos. And now we will upload also the apologetics of the defenders of the Catholic Church. We try to improve and to add more and more. It's growing in the Philippines. We have full tank of Bo Sanchez. We have the men of life of the Archdiocese of Pampanga with Bishop Ambo David. We have Father Denis Soriano from Cubao. We have the missionaries of St. Joseph. And it's growing. More and more people are entering the world of social media. Ang aking layunin ngayon is to invite you. Huwag kayong matakot sa social media. Pumasok po tayo dahil yung masasamang espiritu matagal na pumasok sa Facebook. And it doesn't help just to shut down and to say, ah, basta ako, wala akong Facebook. That's a way of saying to Satan, take over, take control. Ang mundo po ay hindi po pinapanood mula sa labas. Kailangan tumalon at nung nasa gitna ay gumawa ang ating parte. Ang mundo ng social media ay kailangan ng ating presensya. At malaking maitutulong ng Catholic Church sa larangan ng social media. Let's be cyber missionaries. Let me go to the second world. People into drugs. I'm parish priest of Camarin, Caloocan. In my parish, we had 75 people killed because of drugs. 75 in one parish. Pero kami po ay, ano lang, first runner-up to Bagong Silang. Bagong Silang has more than 300. Bagong Silang is a big barangay with 8 parishes. We were really hard-hitted with the war on drugs. And we didn't know what to do, maybe like everybody else. And we were so shocked and surprised. But awa ng Diyos, I have a very good pastoral council. And sa aming meeting ng Paris Pastoral Council, we said, hindi lang pwede tayong manood ng nangyari. At hindi din sapat na tayo ay magdasal lang. We have to do something to help the government in the work against drugs, but we have to do it in a Christian way. And so, some wrong perceptions tungkol sa mga tao na nasa droga. Number one is, all addicts are criminals. This is wrong. Hindi po lahat na nasa droga ay kriminal. I'm sorry to tell you, but this is wrong. Hindi po lahat ay kriminal. Second, hindi po sila salot sa lipunan. Let me expand later. Third, walang pag-asa magbago. Basta nasa droga, walang parang isang journey without return. Walang pag-asa magbago. All these are wrong perceptions. And our communities are safer without addicts. Mabuti pang mawala ng mga addict, maging safe ang komunidad. If you love the world, the principle, if God so loved the world, if we love the world, then you see wounded people and hurting. Yung mga drug addicts ay people very wounded and very hurt. But they are people. Tao po yan. Tao. Number two, sick people with dreams, aspirations, in need of healing. And most probably, I would say, in need of healing like all of us. Minsan hindi po natin tinatanggap. But we all have our own hurts. We all need healing. Marami pala ang mga former addict na may matinong buhay ngayon. So I know many priests that were former addicts. Probably you know Father Bobby from the Archdiocese of Manila. Siya po ang paring in charge ngayon ng community-based rehabilitation program. He was more than 15 years into Shabu. And how he is now a very good priest. Now the other day I was watching a person, the CEO of 7-Eleven, that received a big award internationally That guy was for many years into drugs and in and out of rehab. So to say that walang pag-asa is a lie. Marami ho sa kanila ay talagang nagbago at naging very effective and very active in sa lipunan. Okay? And our communities are safer when the former addicts become active member of the community. Hindi po safer kapag sila ay nawawala. Safer kapag nagbabago. Do we agree on this? Now, I want to share one example. It's our community-based rehabilitation program that we started on September 1. Ako mahirap po. Nung una, mahirap talaga kasi takot ang lahat. Sila'y natukhang at after na natukhang, dahil sa takot, tumagbo sa parokya. And so, ako naman, ako rin, walang idea na anong gagawin. Nasa parokya, gusto daw, sabi ng sekretary ko, susuko sa'yo. Abay. Pwede ba sumuko sa parish priest? Kayo, pwede ba? Pwede ba sumuko ang isang tao? Sa parish priest? Well, now the reality is different. Noong una, hindi talaga pwede. Dapat sumuko sa police. But after walking almost 1 year together with the PNP, they deputized in the city of Caloocan, the parish priest can receive the surrendering of people. That's because for 1 year we worked with the police. Hindi po madali mag-build up yung tiwala sa isa't isa. Hindi po madali mag-push ng agenda natin na ang buhay ay sagrado. And that's, no, hindi po pwedeng patayan lang, bala lang ang katapat. Pero nakita po ng gobyerno na ang ino-offer natin ay hindi patikos, kundi kamay handang tumulong at nagtiwala. At isa sa mga epekto ng tiwala nito ay pag may gustong sumuko, pwedeng sumuko sa parokya. And then the parish will process the papers without going through the... Pero hindi po ito ang pinaka-importante. Ang pinaka-importante is nakasundo kami ng PNP, ng PDEA, that after the rehabilitation, it takes 6 months, daily, araw-araw po yan, Monday to Saturday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. After 6 months, and every week drug test, kapag negative for 3 months, they will be graduated. At anong ibig sabihin ng graduation? Tatanggalin sila ng watch list. And so the first batch was graduated on April, and they receive a certificate, you are declared a drug-free individual, hereby delisted from all the records of the PNP, given by the Chief of Police of Caloocan City. The first group in the country to be delisted na buhay. Hindi ho, cross out dahil... And this took a lot of effort for the whole community, but it's possible. First thing I want to share with you, in whatever topic, we can do something. We cannot do everything. But wala topic na we cannot do anything. May magagawa tayo. Pero let me tell you, ang batikos at yung pananalita lamang ay hindi sapat na gawa. We need to do, real do, things to help. Ang tao na nasa droga, kailangan ng tulong para makalabas ng droga. Ni ang tukhan ay sapat. Dahil hindi makuha sa takot ang pagbabago. A sickness needs professional intervention. And so, the church has a lot of expertise on psychosocial intervention. Yung pong ating kayamanan at yung pong pwede natin gawin. We can do something. Second is, the first question we always should ask is, how can I help? Paano po makakatulong sa problema ito? Yung po naging discussion ng aming pastoral council. Noon, napag-usapan namin ang pataya, we had two groups of thinking. One, some of the PPC members said, let's make a lighting candles para sa namatay, no, as a way of protesting. And then kalahati sabi nila, walang silbi yung kandila lang kung hindi natin matulungan yung buhay pa. Kasi yung may problema yung buhay pa eh, natukhang na, pag hindi magbabago papatayin, anong gagawin sa mga yon? And so eventually this second line of thinking took over. The question was, how can we help? And that's where the community-based rehabilitation program was born. Give a chance, a place, a community, and also the professional intervention that they need. Yun po na decision ng aming parokya. Give these people a chance to change. But also give them a place. Hindi nila alam kung saan pupunta. Pag pinapunta mo sa police station, takot. Kasi siyempre, gumagamit ka ng droga, pupunta ka ng pusa sa police, hindi eh. Sa barangay, takot din sila. Kasi hindi nila alam. Pero sa simbahan, hindi sila takot. So give them a place, allow them to stay in the church. And then give them, above all, a community. Alam ninyo, ang pinakamaganda nangyari sa akin, nung bago ang programang ito, nahirapan kami kung paano silang tawagin. Kasi ako, foreigner po ako, halata no, foreigner. So, medyo, hindi po ako masyadong metikuloso sa mga tamang salita. Kaya, ang tawag ko sa kanila nung una, mga adik, eh, sabi ng mga parishioners ko, para nakakasakit naman ng tandami. Ba't naman, adik naman eh. Okay. Pero, hindi pwede ko sabihin adik. O sige, so, paano nga? Eh, di tawagin natin mga recoveries, o surrenderies, muna surrenderies. But then, hanggang kailan surrender, nag-surrender na dalawang, now recoveries, no. Dapat people with substance abuse. Ay, mahirap yan, Father. Dati sa aming mga squatter, yan ang substance abuse pala yan. Di, nahirapan kami. Hanggang sa yan, isang meeting, I remember, I told the people, why don't we call them by name? Nahirapan pa tayo. Eh, tatapagin natin. Sila Rolly, sila Karen, sila Oliver. Yan, di ba? Ba't kailangan may pangalan pa? Di ba? Let's just call them by name. And that made a click on us. We start to see them not as a different, but another group of the parish. And so, yung pinakamaganda, yung araw ng graduation, nagkaroon sila ng graduation, the mayor was there, chief of police was there, the bishop, and then on the day of the graduation, gave the certificates, the listed from PMP, tuwan-tuwa sila, and then I introduced one by one. I said, ito po si Karen, dati gumamit ng siya po ng 10 taon, ngayon po pinakilala ko sa inyo bagong lektor ng ating parokya. Umo po siya, pangalawa, ito si Oliver, kanyang asawa, mula ngayon, bagong lay minister ng ating parokya. Ito si Jaya, isa-isa po ay pumasok sa isang ministry ng simbahan. And I think that was the biggest point, to make them feel part of the community. Now, 2 weeks ago we had preks. And many of them participate on preks. At isa sa mga parish leader ito ng parokya, kasama mga leader ng parokya, tsaka yung mga adik, na hindi dapat tawagin adik, whatever. Now, isa sa mga leader ng parokya ay tumayo at sabi niya, alam niyo mga kapatid, ako ay police, at mas marami akong kasalanan kaysa sa inyo. But ayokong sabihin in general. So he started, I kill so many people. And I received also under the table for this and that and this and that. And he said, itong Kuya Willy niyo ay isang sinner na pinatawan ng Diyos. Hindi ako iba sa inyo. And they all, yung mga adik, na hindi dapat tawagin ng adik, ay tumayo po sila lahat at niyama po itong si Kuya Willy. And I was so happy. I said, this is it. Ito po yung itong communion. Parang tanggal ko yung maskara, tayo lahat ay may kasalanan, tayo lahat ay nakakamali. Sila ngayon, galit yung presidente sa kanila, so silang kawawa ngayon eh. Eh kung yung next president galit sa mga chismosa, kalahati ng mga parokya, patay. Di ba? I mean, nakataon lang, nagalit siya sa shabu. Hindi, pero alam niyo, I mean, speaking seriously, I told this many times to the police, no? I said, you know, scientifically, alcohol is as bad as shabu. Scientifically, even scientifically, the effect on the brain is worse. Now, ilang po sa mga pulis na galit sa kwan ay alcoholics. Nakataon lang ng presidente ngayon ay galit sa shabu. And thanks be to God, kasi cancer po sa lipunan yung shabu na yan. But we have to remember that it's not the only problem that we have in the country. And any person with a problem, maybe shabu or alcohol, is always welcome in the church. But we need to create a space. Madaling sabihin, you are welcome. Pero kailan? Welcome kailan? Pupunta ako ngayon, may maghihintay sa akin, anong gagawin? So I think what we realize in the parish is we can give them a chance if we give them a place to go. Every day, kasamang pagkain. Siyempre, maghapon ka doon, kakain din. Lahat po yun, kasama. And then, what to do? May mga sessions, kailangan mag-go. May counseling, may psychologist, may psychiatrist. But basically, build community. That's something that the Catholic Church is expert at. We are expert at building communities. Yung pong mission natin, at yun ang pinakakailangan ng mga nasa droga, yung mga addicts na hindi dapat tawagin addicts. Yun po, they are disconnected and they need connection. Yung drugs, painkiller po yan para matanggal yung pain ng disconnection. And so, we can, ito po yung aking advocacy at talagang mahirap, hindi po madali, but we can engage the government because we are trying to serve the same people. Hindi po kailangan awayin ng gobyerno, pwede po tayong makipagtulungan sa gobyerno. Hindi po madali, sa totoo lang, but hindi rin imposible. I think ang ating mission is not to put walls but to create bridges. And it's possible to work with the government. For 1 year, we have been working together. The LGU of Caloocan is sobrang matulungin. Sobrang matulungin. Yung PMP ng Caloocan ay sobrang cooperative. On the national government, hindi kaano ang relationship kasi siyempre kami ay isang barangay. Usually, the barangay don't relay straight to Malacañang. It passed through the LGU. But we have built a relationship with this government by helping. And our way of saying the life is sacred is giving them a place to be saved. And that's our way of saying, itong mga ito, sagrado ang buhay nila kahit duro sa droga, naniniwala na may second chance sila. At basta sa programang ito, huwag na huwag niyong galawin. And they stood their promise. Two months ago, we had a meeting in Ateneo, lahat ng practitioners ng community-based rehabilitation program around the country. This mayroon din sa Mindanao, sa Visayas, sa iba't ibang parte ng Luzon. And we were sharing our stories. We realized, yung mga community na may ganitong programa, nag-drop yung killings. In all the communities with this program, death under investigation, dropped. This is our way. And then, you need to risk your life to save the people. Mas madali po yung Facebook. Sa totoo lang. It was not easy to take the first step on the world of drugs. It was dangerous. We had the threats. It wasn't a walk in the park. Or it was a walk in, sabi ni Miriam Santiago, it was a walk in the park, Jurassic Park. It was a difficult first 2-3 months. But now we are happy as a parish that we risk at the beginning, and we realize that it paid. We are already in the third batch. Now there are 54. under recovery. And the first were six, only six. The second, 15, and now 54. Dahil nawawala mo yung takot, dahil nakita po na hindi po pinapatay, at nakita na nagpabago talaga. And so the community and everybody, and even last Saturday, yung mga friends ko sa Facebook, nakita nyo, I gave a talk to the generals, all the top generals in Camp Kramen. And I was so afraid. Hindi naman napapatayin ako, but to talk about this in front of the generals. But I was also so happy that they reached out. They start to see, and the talk was called An Alternative on the War on Drugs. Sila po naglagay ng titulo, hindi ako. But when I went, I said, thanks God na naisip nyo ito. Kasi we realize na hindi lang balang solusyon. We realize these people can change. But we also realize na madaling sabihin sa inyo, these people can change. Eh wala naman tayong ginagawa. So we realize that it only, our word is only heard when we walk the talk. And so these people eventually start to listen that there is an alternative way. You know, when I was young, noong panahon na yan, nang bata ako, nag-approve yung abortion in Europe and US. And the world, the Catholic world, was on arms against abortion. Many people said abortion is a sin, don't approve abortion, hindi pinapansin. Pero may one person that was really hurt, Mother Teresa of Calcutta, because she went to the United Nations and she said, abortion is the worst crime someone can commit. Please, don't kill them. But she added, send them to me. And that was the big difference. She opened hundreds of orphanages for that, to walk the talk. Kasi madaling sabihin sa isang nanay na buntis, kung mong patayin yung anak sa sinapunan mo. Pero if I don't tell her, what do I do with this? But Mother Teresa was very concrete. She gave the message, don't kill them, but she gave also a solution. If you don't want, give it to me. And it was not rhetoric, hindi po sabi lang. Nagtayo siya ng 100 more orphanages around the world. Alam niyo, sa tingin ko, ha, yung ating simbahan dito sa Pilipinas, lalakas pong ating boses sa harap ng gobyerno when we tell the government, don't kill them, but send them to us. Monday to Saturday, we will give them sessions, psychologists, psychiatrists, food, place, and we will treat them out as our brothers and sisters. But don't touch them kung hindi makita tayo. And I think they will listen, because you don't only denounce, but you are offering a concrete solution. So yung po ang ito pong pagtatapos ng aking presentation. Sa dalawang larangan, social media and drugs, we need to love, not to hate the world. And if we love, we jump into, we do something, and our little something, you believe in the hands of God, yung little nothing ay lumalaki. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. Have a beautiful night. We will open now.